It's delicious.
Plus, I got really good at it.
It's just the right amount of cumin.
And then parmesan.
It's interesting.
It's so good, honey. I love it.
Home, as I knew it, became a thing of the past. So I was getting out a lot.
Come on, guys. Go to class.
They all did. Then Paul hit all the knives.
I'm just gonna say this. Maybe we should send him someplace that knows how to take care of it. Professionally.
I'll still be wanting to start cracking skulls, kid.
You start taking medication.
Son, I'll talk to Jane.
You heard her. You have got to get serious about this trial and about doing well here. Otherwise...
Otherwise what?
No diploma. No culinary school in the fall. This is your last chance, Adam. Sweetie, we can treat this. You remember what the doctor said, but just because you're a person who's dealing with this illness doesn't...
I'm not dealing with itself. It's hard not to feel like that when everyone treats you like one. Be right back.
Mr. Catherine called. She expressed some concerns about your behavior this week.
Having a kid with my mom doesn't make you my dad.
Adam, I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, clearly. When...
Sorry. Dear Sister Catherine, I met Adam a little over a year ago. I don't have much experience with kids, but knowing Adam has taught me that being a parent means becoming what your children need most. Every step of the treatment has been reported, not because we were required to do so, but because it is in Adam's best interest to have the adults in his life be as informed as possible. Your threat to expel him is abusive, and we will not tolerate it. Right now, my son needs me to protect him from narrow-minded people motivated by fear. I have faith that you will make a decision that reflects the moral and spiritual integrity St. Agatha's is built upon.
Paul.
I'm sorry.